So why do you think then, Aisleyne, if someone thinks, oh, I want my lips to be bigger or my breasts to be bigger or my tummy where I've had a baby is all saggy and I want it tightened up, but I can't afford it in the UK, I'm going to go abroad where it's cheaper, and of course sometimes these goes wrong. Why should we then pay for that person's individual choice?
Because that person is a taxpayer also, and NHS are here to be unbiased and treat all of us. If we're in trouble, if we get septicemia, for example, from bad surgery, anyone that's in a position where they need help, that's what the NHS are there for, to help us.
That's true, and there are two sides to every argument. I just want to put this to you. Most people would argue that cosmetic surgery is an individual choice. It's not life-saving surgery. Let's say this. You say taxpayers should be entitled. How would you then, in the same breath, say, when we've got the longest queues ever for people waiting for operations, we have less nurses and less doctors, we have an NHS that is, by everybody's standards, struggling, is it not more important to carry out life-saving operations on the elderly and the young rather than pay
for
men and women?
Obviously, that should take priority, absolutely.
But that's the argument, isn't it? But not the free choice of going and doing it abroad.
People don't go abroad and think, right, I'm going to have real bad problems when I come back.
But
I'm going to have to turn to the NHS.
Do you not think people should take responsibility for a choice that if you have surgery, it's your responsibility. You're taking a risk. You know that when you take it. So you have to deal with that. I myself have had a very bad cosmetic surgery, but I would never dream of looking
in
to someone
UK
else to pay
abroad.
For it. It was abroad.
Yeah, but you get your surgery for free because
I'm sure you've had things for free also
we're
as well.
Lucky
but
enough
I've paid,
to get free
I've paid
surgery
for surgery myself as well. But also, oh God, that picture.
But you haven't asked the question, right?
Okay.
If I said to you that there's that amount of money and it can be given to 10 people who went abroad out of choice and it was botched and they expect the NHS, or 10 elderly people waiting for a hip operation, you've got to answer that question. What's more important?
I think whoever's in a life-threatening situation should get the surgery, regardless of why, if it was self-inflicted or not. Are you then going to say that drug addicts, which you know many of, and alcoholics...
It's outrageous thing to
are you
say.
Then going to say, because it was self-inflicted,
people
that
are
they shouldn't have...
every single day in our country
You're
with
right.
life-threatening illnesses all the time. There's never enough. You know, there's always people that
there
need it
points
more.
There, Chloe.
You know, there's always somebody that needs it.
You know, there are alcoholics.
Yeah.
Many people would argue that is a disease, but there are alcoholics who continue to drink even though they've had warnings that their liver is suffering.
Drug addicts, but on methadone.
There's even hypochondriacs and smokers that need cure for cancer, but that's a separate issue when we're talking about cosmetic surgery, really.
Well, I suppose we're talking about the principle, aren't we, Chloe? So if you go abroad in good faith and pay money for an operation...
Yeah.
And find that operation was performed badly.
Yeah.
You're in a way a victim of fraud.
You
aren't
are
you?
Most definitely, but you take that risk when you choose to go there.
Yeah,
you
but then there's a lot of people in England that have the same surgery and have just as many.
But isn't it the interesting thing?
Honestly,
one thing that we're missing here is that people are saying that they go abroad. Is it always about cost? Is it about probably? Yeah. Where's the advantage, right? Because presumably, if the NHS wasn't as stretched as I said and didn't have to make the rules that it does because it hasn't got as much money as it needs, these people wouldn't have to go abroad. I just think it's a vicious circle. That's all I'm saying.
Well, I think we need to take responsibility and know that, you know, we are promoting foreign surgery.
Yeah,
we need to realise that if you're doing that, then there are going to be people that can't afford to have corrective surgery.
That's true. But also, just because you're going abroad for surgery, it doesn't actually mean you're looking for a cheaper option. Some of the best surgeons in the world are abroad and they're not based in the UK. And sometimes you need to travel to get what you actually want, right? But whether you have a surgery in the UK or you have it abroad, it's at your own risk, right? And I think you should take responsibility for that. It is a selfish choice. No more selfish than buying yourself a pair of shoes or something.
Yeah, but if you then get septicemia or some kind of infection and you know you've got a life-threatening situation, then you should be able to go to the NHS if you're a taxpayer from this country. You should be.
I think life-saving is the phrase.
Yeah.
I think that's what we're talking about.
Okay.
Not I don't like the size, the shape, or whatever. I want it redone. If you've got, I think that's a very relevant
corrective,
point.
If it's corrective, you know, body dysmorphia is just as serious as a lot of things that we can discuss. It's a big suicide rate of people that have really bad body dysmorphia.
Yeah, but I pay into the tax system because, God forbid, if anybody close to me, my family got a life-threatening illness. illness. I would want to know that there's things there that can be done for them. They can go to the NHS and get you know, sorted out. I would be very, very upset if there's somebody with a dodgy cosmetic procedure that is getting that when there's not enough money. We see on Facebook all the time, children, are, you know, things are children are trying to raise money. There's not enough money as it is to sort the things out for people that desperately need
love
it.
Love your passion.
Why great add on to that?
Love your passion.
Well, there's a great passion on both sides for this.
Literally.
That's great. That's great. We stop catfighting. We've got to move on.
Well, no, but I'd love to hear what people think, because I think you both put an absolutely brilliant case.
I'll tell you what I think it is. I think it's okay. Individual choice, isn't it? That's the thing that people
I'm interested to know what people think, honestly. Yeah. I think you can make a case. I think you both made a brilliant case for both sides, so do get in touch. I would love to know what you think. It's a tricky one. You see, they're smiling at each other now. You love each other, really.
High five, girl.
Just got the passion.
Go, girlfriend.
Go, girlfriend.
Where did that come from?
I don't know, but it sat comfortably with you.